Hey everyone, for this video today, I'm going to be talking about some of the words that were in the story of Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. So if you have not seen that video yet or heard me tell you that story, pause, go watch that one, and then this one will make a lot more sense. The first word I wanted to talk about is peddler. Do you remember where this was in the story? Peddler is a person who travels about selling goods, like the peddler went from house to house selling eggs. Do you remember about a peddler in the story? I do. Peddler is in the story when then the queen made herself look like a peddler and went across the seven mountains to the home of the seven dwarves. So that queen dressed herself up as a peddler. Here are some examples of peddlers.
Here you see a woman with baskets balancing on her shoulder, trying to sell some things to make her money. Here is a cart. This is a drawing of a cart, but this is something that you might see around. And this is a book that you might be familiar with called Caps for Sale. Remember, there was a man who had a bunch of caps. He walked around shouting, "Caps, caps for sale," trying to sell his hats. Now, this next example of a peddler is a silly one for a cartoon movie.
Welcome to Agrabah, city of mystery. Enchantment.
The finest merchandise this time of the show, on sale today. Come on down.
Look at this. Yes. Combination hookah and coffee maker. Also makes chili and fries. Will not break. Will not.
It broke. Oh, look at this. I have never seen one of these intact before. This is the famous Dead Sea Tupperware. Listen. Ah, still good.
That makes me laugh every time. The next word here is pity. Pity means feeling sorry for someone. And here's a sentence. Her voice was full of pity when she spoke to the hurt puppy. This word was used in the part of the story with the huntsman. The huntsman took the child into the forest, but he took pity on Snow White and told her to run away. He was supposed to get rid of her, but he started to feel sorry and he said, "Just run away instead." So here's a good example of pity or feeling sorry for someone from a good movie called Inside Out.
Hey, it's gonna be okay. We can fix this. We just need to get back to headquarters. Which way to the train station?
I had a whole trip planned for us.
Hey, who's ticklish, huh? Here comes the tickle monster.
Hey, Bing Bong, look at this. Oh, here's a fun game. You point to the train station and we all go there. Won't that be fun? Come on, let's go to the train station.
I'm sorry they took your rocket. They took something that you loved. It's gone. Forever.
Sadness. Don't make him feel worse.
Sorry.
It's all I had left of Riley.
I bet you and Riley had great adventures.
Oh, they were wonderful. Once we flew back in time, we had breakfast twice that day.
Sadness!
It sounds amazing. I bet Riley liked it.
Oh, she did. We were best friends.
Yeah, it's sad.
I'm okay now. Come on, the train station is this way.
How did you do that?
I don't know. He was sad, so I listened to what...
Hey! There's the train!
So if you haven't seen that movie, the pink elephant character lost something down a giant cliff into a big hole. And the two other characters who were coming by saw him, felt pity for him, felt bad for them, and decided to come and try to help cheer him up. So not only did they feel bad for him, they helped him actually feel better by listening and understanding and letting him tell his feelings. That scene is also a great example of this vocabulary word. This word is wept. Wept is like crying, but even harder crying. It's used in the story about the time when the seven dwarves came home and saw Snow White sleeping. They thought she was dead and they were very upset. It says they all sat around her, all seven of them, and wept. So here are some examples of weeping or people who wept.
I'm entering a sadness spiral.
Disgusting. She's getting tears on me.
Joy, come.
Calm her down!
How about we stop being sad and, hey, look at this!
I'm doing a happy dance.
I'm not wearing any pants. Something, something, France. I'm doing a happy dance. Hey!
Your desperation makes me sad.
I'm sure you could pick out the weeping characters in those video clips. The next word I have is stomped. Stomped means that they walked heavily. So Philippe stomped his feet as he went up the stairs to his room. Do you remember the word stomped in this story? Think about the end when the queen was really upset. It says, in a wild fury, she screamed and stomped her feet. I think we all know what that means. So let's watch video clips anyway.
Dinosaurs have great big feet that stomp, stomp, stomp.
I'm thumping. That's why they call me Thumper.
That bird is so funny. I try to imagine the queen being so angry that Snow White was alive and stomping around with rage, but also walking like that. That's funny. Anyway, speaking of rage, that is this word, rage. Rage means anger. Here's the sentence. It says, when Rodolfo's mom put him in timeout, he was so full of rage, his body shook. And let me read the part in the story where we use the word rage. It says, and when she saw the new bride, she recognized her as Snow White, and she was filled with a terrible rage. Let's watch rage.
Did he just say we couldn't have dessert?
That's anger. He cares very deeply about things being fair.
So that's how you want to play it, old man? No dessert? Oh, sure. We'll eat our dinner right after you eat this.
Yeah. Woo, those characters were very upset, filled with rage. Anyway, so this video is the last video I have in the little unit on kings, queens, and royalty. So I'm glad we got to end it on a fun and silly note. As always, thank you for learning with me, and I will see you next time. Take care.